Hey people, welcome to Game Reviews, your day-to-day tech and game reviewer. Please follow us on social media and subscribe to us on YouTube. Today we are going to talk about the much-awaited MacBook Pro 2016 with Touch Bar. In terms of performance and price, it's an upgrade, and it's totally up to you to decide whether you want to pay the substantial premium for the performance upgrades you get over the previous MacBook Pro. One thing Apple is known worldwide is for designing amazing hardware. And the MacBook design has remained largely unchanged for some time now. And like millions of Apple customers, we actually like the industrial design of the MacBook. Let's talk about the keyboard first. As always, the keyboard is well laid out. However, the key travel is less than the previous MacBook Pro. Apple calls it the butterfly mechanism. We think the new keyboard will take some time to get used to. The trackpad is twice the size of previous MacBook Pro and it uses force touch mechanism. It feels much better and roomy to use. Now the speakers. These are the best speakers ever on a MacBook Pro. The speakers are placed on both sides of the keyboard facing upwards. The sound quality doesn't distort at high volume and voice is crisp and clear. For laptop inbuilt speakers, they doesn't disappoint at all. Let's talk about the newly introduced Touch Bar now. This year, the Touch Bar is touted as the USP of the device. At first glance, it looks like a marketing gimmick than an actual upgrade. But gradually, as we use the Touch Bar, it becomes increasingly clear that the Touch Bar had some pretty niche functionalities upon its sleeves. Fundamentally, what Apple has done is that they have removed the first row function keys of the keyboard and replaced them with a touchscreen bar. It dynamically changes the functionalities in sync with the app being used. The Touch Bar API would be open to developers to utilize with their respective apps, and it would be interesting to see how the developers are going to integrate this to their existing or new apps and utilize the Touch Bar to its full potential. The new MacBook has a new display. It supports the P3 color range, which is 25% wider than the previous MacBook screens. Along with higher brightness and contrast level, with higher pixel density, it becomes the best screen we have ever seen on a laptop. Ports. This is a major point of backlash and everybody we know is not happy with this. All the ports available in the new MacBook Pro are Thunderbolt 3 USB-C compliant ports. While we understand from Apple's point of view, this makes sense. Thunderbolt 3 supports higher data transfer rate, higher voltage and interoperability with USB-C ports, and it seems to be the right way ahead for the future. But this all is happening today and we are not in the future. For any professional laptop, I/O ports are an important part of the package, and by removing the ports like HDMI, full-size USB, legacy Thunderbolt, memory card reader slot, or the MagSafe magnetic charger port, Apple has crippled a good pro laptop into a high-performance entertainment netbook, unworthy of a pro tag. Now let's look under the hood. The base model comes with Intel i5 6th generation processor with 256GB of high performance SSD and 8GB of DDR3 RAM. All these components are upgradable or configurable. Plus on the 15-inch MacBook, you will also get Radeon Pro 450 or 455 graphics chip with 2GB of dedicated DDR5 graphics RAM. This component is also upgradable up to Radeon Pro 460 chipset with 4GB of dedicated DDR5 graphics RAM. But mind you, all these components upgrades come with a hefty price premium. Our final thoughts on the product. Configuration and usability wise, Apple MacBook has always been top notch, and the 2016 MacBook Pro is no different. With high performance Intel processors, huge amount of RAM, and an optional dedicated high performance graphics chip, the new MacBook Pro has a very wide and high performance range. However, the removal of major I/O ports may be and will be a deal breaker for many. Two major factors pulling the MacBook Pro down are unavailability of major ports and premium pricing. Our rating for the MacBook Pro is 6.5 out of 10. But if we exclude the price and ports factor, the rating jumps to 9.5 out of 10. That's it people, that's all we had this time. Don't forget to subscribe to us on YouTube and follow us on social media.